So treatment options include medications, simple medications or sophisticated medications. Rarely pacemakers are in order for this condition. And then the procedure that's becoming more and more popular is the ablation procedure. The ablation procedure tries to isolate those electrical signals and not allow them to leave the pulmonary veins. If they can't leave the pulmonary veins, they can't initiate an episode of atrial fibrillation. In terms of the advantages for the patient, I think that the ablation procedure gives better long-term results and has the ability to hopefully get patients off of medications. My prejudice for most of my patients, if I can get them off medications, that's a big win. So an ablation is a procedure, it's not surgery. The approach for the atrial fibrillation ablation is from the vein of the leg. You go up the vein and into the heart with a catheter. A catheter is basically an electrical wire, the tip of which is able to generate heat. That catheter is introduced to the top left atrium. Then that catheter is steered, moved around the pulmonary veins. It's basically creating a circle around those veins. And the tip of it is able to generate heat in the radio frequency range to try to cauterize the tissue of the atrium so that it can't conduct an electrical signal. So here at Tabora, we do predominantly most of our AFib ablations with robotic ablation. The ablation catheter for robotics is a very flimsy catheter. Instead of it being manipulated and pushed by our hands, it's actually being steered by a computer and magnets that are around the patient. Because it's so flimsy, you put it on the heart tissue, it stays with the heartbeat, as opposed to a stiffer catheter, which would bounce. So we thought it was safer and better. So if you can provide more safety with more efficacy, that's really where you want to have your ablation done.